Am I sharp? I think so. As you can see, this is not a vlog. I will give you some background information before I really start this video. As you all know, I quit filming for a while. I quit making vlogs because I was very busy, and also because there was something wrong with my health that I did not share with you guys. Because I was in the middle of it and I just wanted to get through it and make a new, better start with the vlogs. So I also decided in that time that I wanted to do it in English, because I have a lot of English followers, a lot of international followers that would always ask me to please start filming English so they would understand my vlogs too. So I thought it was time for a change and I started to film in English, and I think I have put 6 vlogs online now that are in English. So that was a big change for me, and also for my followers, of course. But I really got some good feedback, so yeah, I will continue with this and also make this video in English, because I think that a lot of my international followers don't know anything about my medical history. And the rest of you guys don't know what happened in the last few months / weeks. So this video will explain this. I've edited all the old images, so I had to film new ones. I had to film the things that I'm doing right now, but that's not really a lot. As my Dutch followers know, I had a big lung surgery in 2017. They removed half of my left donor lung because there was something small in it that wasn't supposed to be there. And if they hadn't done that, then I wouldn't be sitting here right now. So I am very grateful that they discovered this in very, very early stage. After this big, big surgery, I had to recover for 4 weeks, and then they advised me to, although it was gone and everything was good, to do 8 chemo treatments. As you can imagine, it was a very bad year for me. I had to recover from all this, and I think it took me like a year before I really understood what had happened to me the past year. So yeah, that was a very hard time for me and my family. But I'm doing a lot better now. My lungs are fine. My 1.5 donor lung are fine. So I'm really grateful that everything turned out this way. But as you know, I also have diabetes type 1. So I have to inject myself with insulin like 4 or 5 times a day. And managing your diabetes when you're sick, when you're working out hard or just doing nothing, is really hard to manage. When you want to manage your diabetes, you have to live as structured life as possible. And as you all know, my life is very hectic. I have a very hectic job. It's hard. So that was 2 years ago, and I lost a lot of muscle weight in that time. My body was very weak, so really needed to rest and to regain strength. I've worked very hard on that, and I think the last 6 months really I stepped up my game. I went back to the gym. I regained muscle strength. I totally changed my diet, because I was having some belly issues also. And all that really affected my body's need for insulin. People with diabetes will understand what I mean, but to make it simple, your body's need of insulin really depends on how active you are that day. And because I am a lot more active the last few months, my body needs less insulin. So it turned out that I had really low sugar levels, like 2 or 3 times a day, and that really, really makes you feel very tired. I had really bad nights. I couldn't concentrate, I couldn't read, I couldn't write, and as you can imagine, that's really horrible with the job I have. So I was really struggling the last few weeks. So I decided to change up my diet also because there were some issues with my belly, some things that my belly wouldn't digest, and I got a lot of belly aches, and that also influenced my sugar levels. So I told you guys a few weeks ago on Instagram that I totally changed my diet. I wanted to find out what was making my belly ache. So I skipped a lot of things and then I put them back in my diet one by one so I could see how I would react on each one of them. And it turned out that I cannot really digest anything dairy. So I really have a belly ache when I drink milk, when I eat cheese, when I eat whipped cream, when I eat chocolate. So I'm really glad that I know that now because I haven't had any belly aches since I stopped eating those things. So that was one big change that I had to make the last few months / weeks. So when my belly calmed down because I wouldn't be eating those things anymore, I could really look at my sugar values, my glucose values, to see and make them better. I still had a lot of low sugar, so what I just told you, bad nights, couldn't read, couldn't write, really feeling awful. And what I mean by focusing purely on my glucose values and how I eat is that I would measure every meal, measure everything that I ate, because in that way I could calculate how much insulin I needed for how much carbs I ate. I'm doing that with the help of an expert, but this takes time to find out how my body is reacting at food and how much insulin it needs right now in the condition that I have right now. So that's what I've been doing the last couple of weeks. I didn't go out much. I didn't go to the events that I was invited to because I simply could not manage what I drink or ate there. So it wasn't possible for me. I'm still in this process, but it's going a lot better. I have better nights now. Luckily, as you saw in my latest video, in the concert building, you saw like 3 bags under my eyes, and now you know why I look that way. So after feeling very, very awful in the last few weeks, months, I'm finally starting to feel somewhat better. I still have to take naps sometimes in the afternoon because I'm just too tired, because my body needs a lot of rest and healing from the past few weeks, months. So that's what my situation is right now. It's getting better, but it was very hard for me to do normal stuff in the last few weeks. And that's not something that I show on social media because I myself look at social media because I want to see fun stuff. And so I also want to share fun stuff, but it isn't totally fair if I vlog my life and only show you all the good things and the events that I'm going to while I'm laying in bed the rest of the day, and that's something that you don't see. So it seemed like I was doing only fun stuff, but this was really what's going on. This is also a big part of my life and will always be, so that's why I decided to share this story with you guys. And I didn't have enough videos to put up a vlog today, so I thought this was a nice moment. I just edited all my old images and wanted to start the new videos, but before I start the new videos, I would like you to know that this is what happened in my life the last few weeks that I didn't film. So what now? I'm planning on putting up a video twice a week on Sundays and Wednesdays. Yeah, I'm looking forward to making new videos. There's a lot of fun things that are going to happen, so not worrying about fun stuff that I can share, but I just wanted you to know what happened to me the last few weeks and what I am still struggling with right now, although it's going better, so that's what I'm really happy about. And yeah, I hope to see you in my next video that will be up on Sunday, and hope you have a nice day. Bye.